know, my strategy was to go down to the south end and pick out a few waves at the beginning of the heat, but kind of failed me towards like halfway and had to stick to the old school Huntington thing and to go by the pier and pick out a couple. I knew I'd come back somewhat, but didn't know whether I was going to get nines or whatever, so I had the right wave, didn't actually know if I should go on it, look like close out, so I was just stoked to make it through the close one.
I only have a couple results, so right now it's like a must for me to get a couple points here. You know, it's home, and I think it's just, you know, I'm ready. You know, it's better. I've had my 4 or 5 years in the event, and then a couple years on tour, so just learning, and yeah, I'm ready to win.
Just basically looking for anything with a lip that do critical maneuvers, and it's challenging out there, especially with the tide coming up. You know, it's hard to find those sections, and I got lucky. I was just trying to go for anything that looked like it had a wall, a left or right, and hit off. I figured I had to choose good scores, and I was just going to play my own game and try and get out of their guys' way, because, you know, they got to do what they're doing. And I was trying to get up here on the far left, and it just turned out it right came to me at the end that I was happy to get a wave in to the beach. It's always better than paddling.
It always feels so good to start off with a 9. You get a 9, and you know you just want to go get something else solid. You know you don't need you don't necessarily need another 9. Like I said, my second wave was a 7.8, and you know, to get a 7.8 that I'm sitting on, you know, I sit on 16.8 points. That's a really good score. So at that point, I was really stoked, and I knew that I could just go out and have fun. So I was just looking for ways to have fun, and obviously I still wanted to better my score, but I knew most likely I wouldn't have to. So I just wanted to start having fun, and I got that wave, you know, knowing that I could just surf how I wanted. I went for a huge air, and you know, luckily I pulled it off and got another 9. And at that point, I was going to maybe paddle in then, but I feel kind of a little weird paddling in that early, but I have the Boost Mobile Trials later today, and I wanted to save some energy for that, so I was trying to just relax after that point and just, you know, I had to stay out there and try some more things, have fun, but you know, I gotta save energy for later today. I really want to do well in that and make it in the Boost Mobile Pro.
I was a little nervous. I was kind of you know, just having Tanner, my heat makes it a little extra nerve-wracking. You know, I felt like, you know, just happy to make it and hopefully kind of iron out the little kinks and stuff and sort of hit a stride a little bit later. So when he has a tough, or when someone has tough heat before me, that can throw me off. But, you know, like for him to have a great, he was like, all right, it's game on. You know, Dane's crushing it. I got to step it up. So, yeah, I felt pretty excited to watch his heat this morning. He got some good ones. You know, he surfed a great heat, Tanner. I mean, he got a lot of good waves and, you know, I think he'll just carry that momentum into his juniors final. So he asked me, like, what do I think he should do? And, you know, I just said you should try and better your score because I think the other guys only need, like, mid-range scores. And it's just tough when the tide is so high that it's difficult to get your outside maneuvers, you know? So you kind of, it's really tough to say whether you want to sit close to a guy or whether you want to, you know, try and better your score because you never know. You may not better a 5 out there. It's easily going to happen, so...